In this video, I am going to explain basic anatomy of hamstrings. You know, hamstrings is on the posterior part of the thigh. There are three muscles in hamstring. This one, and this one. I'm going to explain their name first. Okay, what is this one? This is on the lateral part. So this is biceps femoris. Biceps femoris. Actually, there are two heads in biceps femoris. What you see is long head of biceps. And what you don't see is there is short head deep to the long head. Imagine there is a muscle deep to long head. So this is long head. Long head. Deep to long head, there is short head. Biceps femoris is on the lateral part of the thigh, okay? There are two other muscles. What is this one? This one is semitendinosus. Semitendinosus. This is on the medial part, semitendinosus. And this one is semimembranosus. 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 So there are three muscles. Biceps femoris, semitendinosus, and semimembranosus. Now on the next part, I'm going to explain its origin and insertion. Okay, this is closer view. All three hamstrings attach on here. This part is ischial tuberosity. Ischial tuberosity is part of ischium. This part is also known as sit bone. Okay, ischial tuberosity. So biceps femoris, semitendinosus, and semimembranosus, these three muscles attach on ischial tuberosity. Okay, now let's look at insertion. Now, this is biceps femoris, semitendinosus, semimembranosus. Biceps femoris attaches on the head of fibula. Head of fibula. Fibula. Remember, this is on the lateral part. Okay? So, semitendinosus and semimembranosus attach on tibia. But I'm just giving you the simple information because especially semimembranosus had so many attachments around tibia. This is very, very important muscle. But now in this video, you just remember semitendinosus and semimembranosus attach on tibia. This is medial part. Okay? Biceps femoris, head of fibula. Semimembranosus and semitendinosus, they attach on tibia. Okay? Now let's look at their function. Now you are looking hamstrings from profile view. Imagine this is the hamstrings. This is the medial part. You are looking the semimembranosus and semitendinosus. Imagine hamstrings attach here. This is ischial tuberosity. And this is knee. You see the tibia here. So this is hamstrings. There are two main functions in hamstring. One is hip extension. Hip extension. Bring leg backward. This is very, very important. But before I'm going to explain you the hip extension, let me explain the knee flexion. Hamstrings also does knee flexion. Knee flexion is bending knee, but in daily life, hip extension is more important in my opinion. Because do we do knee flexion with maximum power? Maybe not, unless you go to gym. Compared to knee flexion, we use hip extension a lot. When do we use hip extension? When we walk, when we run. It's part of daily activity, right? So in daily life, hip extension is more important compared to knee flexion. I'm not saying knee flexion is unnecessary. It is important, but I'm talking about in daily activity. Hip extension is very, very important. And few more minor functions. Let's say this is a inside of the hamstring, semimembranosus and semitendinosus. These two do internal rotation of knee. Internal rotation of knee joint. Let's say biceps femoris is on the lateral part. Biceps femoris does lateral rotation of the knee joint. Lateral rotation. But I think these knee rotation are not very important compared to knee flexion and hip extension. Again, I am not saying these two are unnecessary. These are necessary, you know, but I think hip extension is the most important function in hamstring. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of hamstrings. I explained its name, origin, insertion, and function. I hope this video helps your understanding of anatomy. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.